One person who's not a House member but does have considerable sway over many of them is the Fox News host Tucker Carlson, who is no fan of Kevin McCarthy.
Unless conservatives get their act together right away, Kevin McCarthy or one of his highly liberal allies, like Elise Stefanik, is very likely to be Speaker of the House in January. That would mean we will have a Republican Congress led by a puppet of the Democratic Party.
Ouch. Ouch. Yeah.
You were talking about the former president, Donald Trump, and how much time there is between now and when this vote would take place. There are several months, and as we've seen with the former president, he's your friend one day, but you say something another day that really upsets him, and then he's suddenly not very loyal to you anymore. So there's a lot of running room here. Even if there isn't anyone else, there's plenty of time for someone, I guess, to emerge who could challenge him for that. But Republicans are signaling, John, and this, I think, is the important part, that they are most focused on taking back the House at this point in the election so they can even get to that point. When you look at the comments by the NRCC chair, for instance, who's in charge of taking it back, they're also making comments about, oh, this is a thing of the media. They want to squarely keep the focus on President Joe Biden and Democrats and taking back those seats so they can even get to a point where they're having a discussion about who's going to be the next speaker.
I've been doing this for a long time, and Republicans have always been more disciplined than Democrats at keeping their family feuds, trying to keep them private. Fight it out in the room, don't fight it out publicly. That has been a trademark of Republicans forever. The question is, though, can this be sustained in the sense that, or even if McCarthy remains as leader, is he weakened? Because he's lied to his own members. He has lied publicly. Does he have the credibility? This is one snippet of a call where he's talking. You hear Kevin McCarthy and you hear his deputy, Steve Scalise, talking about things that Matt Gaetz was saying after the election and around the time of the insurrection. And they are sounding an alarm. Listen.
So I'm calling Gaetz. I'm explaining to him. I don't have much to say, but I'm going to have some other people call him too. But the nature of what, if I'm getting briefing, I'm going to get another one from the FBI tomorrow. This is serious shit to cut this out.
Yeah, that's shit. I mean, it's potentially illegal what he's doing.
Well, he's putting people in jeopardy.
Yeah. It's the number one and the number two in the House Republican Conference talking about things Matt Gaetz was saying after the election around the insurrection. Matt Gaetz responding, this is from yesterday, before the meeting today, Representatives McCarthy and Representative Scalise held views about President Trump and me that they should shared on sniveling calls with Liz Cheney, not us. This is the behavior of weak men, not leaders. Matt Gaetz normally does align himself with Marjorie Taylor Greene, Paul Gosar, Andy Biggs, a few others. He seems to be an outlier at the moment, but emphasizing at the moment.
Yeah, I mean, look, I think Matt Gaetz is going to be probably the biggest problem for Kevin McCarthy. He is not just vocal on these sorts of issues, but he is going to be trying to rally other MAGA world Republicans in the House to try to turn against Kevin McCarthy specifically on this issue. And, you know, it's interesting because when this whole scandal started exploding last week, we were hearing from House Republicans who specifically said, you know, watch what McCarthy says about kicking members off Twitter. You know, he's been very critical of Twitter publicly, saying, you know, Twitter shouldn't be kicking off conservatives. They shouldn't be doing censorship of this and that. And then privately, he's saying these members are dangerous enough that they shouldn't have their Twitter handles at all. And so that in particular, we were told, was going to be particularly damaging for him. And right now, it looks like people are giving him a pass. But you just a few minutes ago brought up this point of, is he losing capital? And, you know, the more that these sorts of things come out, it's absolutely going to grade in terms of the support he has with his membership. So people will remember this. They might be giving him a pass right now. But as you said, the speaker's race is a very long time away, and a lot of shoes could drop between now and then.
Giving him a pass right now and seeing what they can get for their support. You mentioned the Twitter thing, which is a huge issue right now, obviously with Elon Musk buying Twitter, but a big issue among conservatives anyway. Kevin McCarthy said he never said any specific member should be kicked off Twitter. Listen here. The first voice you hear is a House Republican aide. Then you'll hear McCarthy.
Moore also made this tweet on Saturday night as the U.S. Capitol police officer who shot and killed a woman as he tried to get into the lobby. So he tweeted at Marjorie Greene and at NARAL, I understand it was a black police officer that shot the white female veteran. You know, that doesn't fit the narrative.
What?
Ow.
Oh, man.
This is what we have to confront with this.
Can't they take their Twitter accounts away, too?
There it is, right there. That's his voice. I mean, he cannot deny what he said. He can try to spin it and say, I said other things, too. That's only a piece of the context. That after saying he didn't say what you hear him say.
Right. I also think it's interesting that he was seemed sort of genuinely surprised, I guess, by what his own members were saying. And as someone who's been sort of talking to a lot of members of his conference and keeping tabs on, you know, how MAGA world has evolved, he seemed to be surprised. And, you know, the sort of "oh man" in his voice, I think he genuinely, it seemed, felt that they were a problem at the time and could incite more violence, which, you know, the audio is pretty clear on that.
And yet did nothing about it.
Yet did nothing about it.